गुड मॉर्निंग आई एम शिवयोगी शिवराजन फ्रॉम कोयंबतूर तिरुमूलर योग सिद्धपीठम नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द रिलेशन बिटवीन प्राणायाम एंड लाइफ स्पैन द नंबर ऑफ इयर्स वन lives is decided by the number of breaths one takes and leaves every day. Normally, according to yoga literature, if one breathes 21,600 breaths every day, he will live for 100 years. If one reduces the number of breathings and extends the breathing process, that is, one takes a long breath and reduces the number of breaths every day, he will live long. In Tirumandiram, Tirumular Maharishi explains how a man who lives for 100 years breathes for 80 years, one who lives for 80 years breathes. He explains the breathing pattern of persons who live for 50 years, 33 years, 28 years and 25 years. In the same way, he also explains how by doing pranayama, one can extend his life, extend his lifespan. He explains in this Tirumandiram. In verse 571, he says, inhalation, exhalation, and retention both ways. These signs of breath thus consisting, they know not. They who know the signs of breath are destined to span the guard of death. That is, if one knows the art of breathing, he can elongate his lifespan and kick guard of death. That is, he can postpone death. So, in the same way, he explains in verse 796 that breathing pattern and lifespan are interconnected. Tirumular scientifically explains how the ratio between inhalation and exhalation decides the lifespan. If one inhales for 12 matras and exhales for 4 matras, he will live up to 100 years. In verses 774, he says, if one inhales for 12 matras and exhales 6 matras, the age is 80. The English translation is, if prana flows outward in matras, 66 in length, 80 years you live up to. In verse 774, he also says, if one exhales for 12 matras and exhales for 7 matras, one lives up to 62 years. In verse 774, he also says, the translation is, if prana flows outward in matra 7, you live up to 62 years. Know clearly, he says. In the same way, a man who lives up to 50 years inhales for 12 matras and exhales for 8 matras. In verse 775, he says, if the 8 matras prana runs out through nostril left, 50 the age you know. So, a man who lives up to 33 years breathes as below. In verse 775, he says, if prana is leaving out in 9 matras, 30 and 3 the age be. The man who lives up to 28 years inhales 12 matras and exhales for 10 matras. In verse 776, he says, if in matra 10 it flows out in nostril left, 28 the life here be. In the same way, a person who lives up to 25 years inhales for 12 matras and exhales 15 matras. In verse 776, he says, if the exhalation is 15 matras, then the age is 20 and 5. So, knowingly or unknowingly, if the breath is elongated, if the breath number of breaths increases, and the exhalation count, that is, if the exhalation, sends out more prana during breathing process, his life becomes short. See, that is, 12 matra inhalation is there. One should send out 4 matras prana from this body. Then only one can live for 100 years. If one sends more prana during breathing process, his life becomes shorter. He explained all these things now. Now, he explains by doing pranayama practice, we can expand our lifespan. He explains how it can be done. In verse 569, he says, if you control the breath within, however old your body, young and crystal hard it turns. That is by doing kumbhaka. A retention is called kumbhaka. If you retain air within, then your body will harden and it will gain strength and it will last for a long time. This kumbhakam gives rest to lungs. Kumbhakam means suspending breathing. When you withhold air inside lungs, the lungs will stop contraction and expansion. So it takes rest. And when it takes rest, a pleasing sensation will be caused in the brain. The heartbeat will also come down. So during ordinary pranayama, one takes 4 breaths. But during kumbhaka, by practicing kumbhaka, we can do only 1 breath in the time of 4 breaths. So by doing kumbhaka, that is we can save 3 breaths. When we save 3 breaths, our lifespan will be increased. The same way, sea tortoise. The sea tortoise live for 500 years, a long lifespan. When we see the breathing pattern of sea turtles, it inhales very, very slowly and retains the air within for a long time and exhales slowly. So by this slow breathing process, it lives for a long time. The yogis also might have followed this pattern, some say. But dogs and cats, which live for a shorter period, breathes in a faster manner. So by slowing down the breathing process, one can elongate the lifespan. Another point is, by practicing this pranayama, if one joins this prana and apana together, then also he will postpone death. That is, he says in verse 574, if you join prana and apana with retention, you can sit erect, vanquishing death. If one gives importance to left nostril breathing, then also one can live for a long time. In pranayama, we give preference for breathing through left nostril, because the left lungs in the right side have 3 lobes. But in the left side, only 2 lobes are there, because within the chest cavity, the heart is also present in the left side. So, the left side lungs is less in volume. To compensate this, one who does pranayama does more breathing through left nostril. If he does this, then also he will live for a long time, says Saint Thirumoolar. He is a great yogi who wrote in Tamil. In verse 570 he says, whenever you inhale through left, and the body will then perish not. Left side. So this pranayama, by doing this pranayama, we can elongate our life span. If moreover the mind and prana breathing process are interrelated, if the mind works in harmony with our breathing, then also one can live for a long time. That is, the disturbances in mind will cause stress, and the stressful life is makes one live shorter. So if one's mind works in unison with the breathing, then he will have control over mind. His mind will be calm and placid, so he will become stress free. When the mind is quietened, the number of breaths will also come down. Then also one will live for a long time. He says in verse 567, let prana and mind merge together. The two be stilled, then no more shall birth and death be. So, this is another way to elongate the life span is when our breathing is contained in less number of nadis, the life will be increased. In verse 700 he says, the life breath that rose with Tani Nayagi, filled with nadis 539 and remained in Sakti total absorbed. In our Sushumna, that is in between our eyebrows, this is the opening of Sushumna. It is the junction box of 10 pranas. The 10 pranas meet in between the eyebrows. There 539 nadis are working. And if you fill these nadis with the prana, then also one will live for a long time. The same way, if you reduce the number of breathing through long breaths to 238, then the prana will be in unison with the causal energy, Om. When it comes like this, the life will be expanded for manifold times. In verse 701 he says, when life breath fills the nadis 238, the prana will act in unison with the Om. Okay, then another, by doing pranayama, one can keep the three dosas, that is vada, pitta and kapha, in a balance. If a vada becomes excess, or a pitta becomes excess, or plum becomes excess, then also the health will be disturbed. By doing pranayama, we can keep these three in balance, that he says in verse 727. As the body attains wax-like suppleness, practicing yoga at dusk clears excess phlegm. At noon leaves excess vada treacherous. At dawn practice excess pitta will be cleared. Thus all poison from body is expelled. You shall know graying and wrinkling. That is why if you keep vada, pitta and kapha in balance, the body will be young, then the anti-aging process will be there. If you do pranayama in a right pattern, though the number of years you live is high, the body will look young, it will work young. These are the Siddhas' ways. The Siddhas have the Siddhas from Tamil Nadu have explained these techniques. So this by doing pranayama we can have a control over our lifespan. We can decide our lifespan, and that is written clearly in Tirumantra. So by this ways, by explaining this Tirumandram way, we are teaching, we are conducting classes to practice pranayama. For needs, you can contact me at mystictirumoola@gmail.com. mystictirumoola@gmail.com. Thank you.